Good morning, my dear student. Today is 27 December 2017, Wednesday, and I am presenting you the newspaper analysis of the Hindu. Today we are going to study about the seven topics which are given here. The first is the line of control and international boundary between India and Pakistan. Normally, sometimes little bit confusion arises regarding the international boundary and the difference between international boundary and line of control. From that perspective, I have taken the front news and I will explain it. Shravan Belagola, Bahubali and the Jain religion related to that, this news is important. We will discuss about this part. This is important for the history and culture point of view. North Korea conflict and International Atomic Energy Agency. This is the editorial on which we will again discuss. It will be updated. The North Korea conflict, International Atomic Energy Agency, has been discussed earlier also. Some of you have written the write-up also. Yeah, and you require to make again the revision of the same write-up. The pod taxi in Delhi, a new concept in the transportation is coming, on which the news will be there. Inequality is a very important concept, and today we have got a very interesting article, very good article, between the inequality, what are the parameters in India and in China, a comparison has been made. Very interesting article, you should preserve this article for the future reference, and as well as you have to refer it with the Uncertain Glory book of the Amartya Sen and as well as the Jean Darej, Uncertain Glory. Indian Patent Law Section 3D. Indian Patent Law, my dear students, this is a topic of the science and tech, and directly the patents are very important, intellectual property rights, IPR. In that context, the Indian Patent Law Section 3D is important. Sometimes the questions related to that are also being asked. In the Indo-China relationship, one interview is there the Kra Canal, which is on the Thailand, that canal is there, which is linking the South China Sea with Andaman Nicobar Island Sea. So these seven news are important. Let us try to understand the news page by page from today's newspaper of the Hindu. The frontline news, that is three Pak Jawan killed in cross LOC raid, line of control. See, LOC, cross LOC raid, in this context, the LOC, line of control, line of actual control, and the international borders, these points becoming sometimes important. These three words are being used more often, the line of control, line of actual control, and international border. In context of Indo-Pakistan, let us try to understand this point. In this map, let us see the international border written here, international border. Let me draw with red color. International border, it is there. This is the international border, Redcliffe line. The India and Pakistan border, also known from here to this part, these are known as the international border. It is running between India and Pakistan and demarcates the Indian states and four provinces of Pakistan. There are the four provinces of the Pakistan. The border runs from the line of control from here. This is the line of control at this point, which separates the Indian-controlled Kashmir and Pakistan-controlled Kashmir in the north to Wagha border, which partitioned the Indian Punjab state and Punjab province of Pakistan to the east. The zero point separates the Indian states of the Gujarat and Rajasthan to Sindh province of Pakistan in the south. This line was drafted and created based upon the Redcliffe line in 1947, the border which divides Pakistan and India from each other. It traverses a variety of terrains ranging from the major urban areas to inhospitable deserts. So these are the international borders. Okay. From the Arabian Sea, the naval border follows the course of the Manora Island of the Pakistan to the course of Mumbai Harbour in the southeast. These are the international borders. This type of border is internationally recognized and the legal. These are the international recognition are there and these are the legal are there. An agreement is signed between the two countries regarding sharing the border. It is clearly demarcated. For example, India shares this international border with Myanmar also, and this side Myanmar also, with Bangladesh also, Bhutan, Pakistan, this Redcliffe line up to this point. Now let us see the line of control. It is the de facto border. This one, the red color line, this line of control, here it is written. This one is the de facto border. line, and de facto, and it is the shared by India and Pakistan, dividing Kashmir controlled by India. This Kashmir is controlled by India, and the other part of the Kashmir controlled by Pakistan. The line of control has its roots in the ceasefire lines, and which was drawn up in 1948. If you recall that in 1948, there was an invasion, and it was formally accepted. It was the first war between India and Pakistan, and after that, this was the line of control, because India has gone to the international court. It was formally accepted by both India and Pakistan government in 1972 also. This was the Shimla Agreement, 1972. We have seen in our geography first class. And after the third war between India and Pakistan, 1971, the Shimla Agreement was there. LOC is neither internationally recognized nor it has any legal status. It is demarcated by the militaries. That is, demarcation was recognized by both the governments in 1972 in the Shimla Agreement, but no international recognition. The other two types of the border about which I was telling, that these are the line of actual control. There's line of actual control, and there is also open border. Like open border is there, what? At which place? Between India and Nepal. Most of the borders are open only. There is actual ground position line. Suppose if there is a war at Kargil, at that time the actual ground position war is there. Now what is the news at present? The ceasefire in the Rajouri sector. This is the Rajouri sector where the ceasefire was there. It was the actual, this is line of control area. So this was the tit for tat action and the counter-terrorist activities and all those things. So from that perspective, this news is there. So my dear students, line of actual control, line of control, actual ground position line, and international boundary. I think this concept is clear to you. Now, this news draws my attention that Karnataka plans temporary township at Shravan Belagola. It is needless to say that Shravan Belagola is in Karnataka state, approximately 135 km from the Bangalore. This is the Gomateshwar statue at Shravan Belagola. It is one of the most important tirthas in Jainism, one that reached a peak in architectural and sculptural activity under the patronage of the Western Ganga dynasty of Talakad. So this we have read in the history, that it is one of the most important tirthas, that the pilgrimage destination in Jainism, Shravan Belagola. And this tirtha has reached its peak in the architectural and sculptural activities under the patronage of the Western Ganga dynasty. And if you recall that in history class, we have seen that Western Ganga dynasty of the Talakad. Okay, so this is important from the civil services perspective, that from in which area it was found. Chandragupta Maurya was also, we have seen that Chandragupta Maurya is also said to have died here in the 289 BC approximately, before Christ, after he became a Jain monk and assumed the ascetic lifestyle. This Shravan Belagola, that place is important. It has two hills. One is the Chandragiri, one is the Vindhyagiri. Acharya Bhadrabahu and his pupil Chandragupta Maurya are believed to have meditated here. The Bhadrabahu. Chandragupta Basadi, which was dedicated to Chandragupta by Maurya, was originally built here by the Ashoka. So from that perspective, in the examination, the questions had been asked. Chandragupta Maurya, the Ashoka, in the 3rd century BC. And this is a 58 feet tall statue, 58 feet tall monolithic statue of the Gomateshwar, is located in the Vindhyagiri Hill. It is considered to be the world's largest monolithic statue. World's largest monolithic, from the single rock it has been made, monolithic statue. The base of the statue has an inscription in Prakrit Devanagari script. It is dating back to 981 AD. That this the inscription praises the king who founded the fort and general. These all things are there. This Gomateshwar or the by the Kannadigas, but the Jain refer this as the Bahubali also. Bahubali. The Gomateshwar or Bahubali. There is a Mahamastika Abhisheka, Mahamastika Abhisheka Bahubali Mahamastikabhishekha function is there in this year only, in February month, I mean 2018, this is going to be celebrated. So my dear students, these all important aspects have been discussed here. Monolithic statue, Ganga dynasty of the Talaka, 29 BC, Ashoka, Bahubali, Mahamastikabhishekha. These all concepts are related to this statue. This news is of little bit significance that rupees 4000 crore project is to start of with 12.3 km Delhi-Gurugram pilot corridor on public-private partnership basis. So this is the future prospective programs, the 4000 crore programs are there. These are the pod taxi. Pod taxi means 4 or 5% will be there, and it is a pilot-less taxi. And this taxi will be at very economical rate, it will run. So this is important from that perspective in the futuristic point, monorail, pod taxi, the new, whatever the inventions are there in the metro line or the bullet train, these all are important to some extent. Related to the Ministry of Road Transport and Highway, etc. So from that perspective, this news is important. And this taxi is operational in London at the Heathrow Airport also. So from that, from there, we have got the inspiration for this type of running of taxi in Delhi only. The news related to this one, that is North Korea sanctions, the North Korea conflict, and after the intercontinental ballistic missiles firing by the North Korea, the trial has been made by the North Korea. There was a speculation that yes, they had also made the trial for the hydrogen bombs, and they have told that yes, North Korea has got the capability even to go up to any part of the North America. After that, the sanction, the United Nations Security Council, United Nations Security Council has made this sanction. From that perspective, that 89% curbs are there, so that no any crude oil, petroleum, etc. will go there. In this sanction, we are getting that yes, some pressure is also there from the Beijing on the Pyongyang. Pyongyang is the capital of the North Korea. So from that perspective, this news is important. Here we are finding that one aspect, that International Atomic Energy Agency, that how much this inspection has to be made by the International Atomic Energy Agency may not mean much to Mr. Trump, given to the overall distrust of the multilateral institutions. But in our context of the International Atomic Energy Agency, we must have one idea. And in the earlier classes also, we have discussed about the International Atomic Energy Agency. This International Atomic Energy Agency is an international organization that seeks to promote peaceful use of the nuclear energy, peaceful use of the nuclear energy, and to inhibit its use for any military purpose. It is a peaceful, and it inhibits the military purpose, peaceful. That is the main purpose, including nuclear weapons. The International Atomic Energy Agency was established as an autonomous organization in 1957. Though established independently of the United Nations through its own international treaty, this International Atomic Energy Agency reports to both United Nations General Assembly and Security Council. So United Nations Security Council also reports there, and United Nations General Assembly also. Though it is not directly under United Nations, it has got its evolution by an international agreement. It is having its headquarters at Vienna. We have seen in some of the classes it has many regional safeguard offices at different places, Switzerland also. It serves as an intergovernmental forum of scientific and technical cooperation in the peaceful use of the nuclear technology and nuclear power worldwide. The program of the International Atomic Energy Agency encourages the development of peaceful application of nuclear technology, provide international safeguards against misuse of nuclear technology and nuclear materials, and promote nuclear safety, including radiation protections, nuclear security standards, and their implementations. For their effort, they have got the Nobel Peace Prize in 2005 also, and we know that related to the treatment of the cancer, etc. also, this nuclear materials, nuclear medicines, these are being used. These all comes under the International Atomic Energy Agency Forum only. It is an autonomous organization, so not under direct control of the United Nations. That is important, and on this aspect only, in the civil services, in earlier occasions, question has been asked. So the International Atomic Energy Agency exists for the purpose of the safe, secure and peaceful usage of the nuclear science and technology. It executes this mission with three main functions, that it does the inspections. And from that perspective, the North Korea conflict, this is important, that who will inspect that North Korea is having nuclear capability for the military use or not. This is the International Atomic Energy Agency. I have made this concept clear by making all the points to your consideration, so that when questions will be asked, who will inspect? Then International Atomic Energy Agency, because they are having the mandate for the safety and security of the nuclear facilities. And from that purpose, this news is important, and this one, the North Korea conflict, you can add one more point here. You know very well the history of the North Korea conflict, for which I have told you that, my dear students, please go on the Views on News series. There you will have the North Korea conflict in the historical perspective also. The article Countering Growing Inequality is very important from our civil services perspective, especially in the main examination. Usually this type of the questions are usually being asked. That Indian social policy must realize health and education level. My dear students, mind the word. This one is very noticeable words, health and education levels, all around as China has done. This is talking about the inequality. Inequality, we have seen earlier that in World Inequality Report 2018 has come. Very important. Uncertain Glory book, we have read, in that also inequality has been discussed. Here now the report has come, 2018 World Inequality Report. And here we are finding that, the report finding that the top 1% of the income earners received 6% of the total income in the early 1980s. That in India in 1980, 1% of the population was getting almost 6% of the national income. You just see inequality was there. But when you are coming to 2000, we are finding that 1% of the population is getting the national income, I mean the income share of 15%, close to 15%. Means inequality has arisen, inequality has grown between these 20 years. And now in the 2017, we are finding that this 1% of the population are having the income of the 22% of the national income. Means they are having this much. You just see how much, 1%, 22%, means rest 99% are depending on 78% of the income. This is such inequality. If you compare in China, this 22%, in China it is only 14%. So in comparison to India, in China there is less inequality. What is the reason? This point has been discussed by the author, that in China they have invested more on the health and education. Health and education. In India, the education level and the employable education level is very low. We are having very poor education standard. But in China, even in 1970, the Chinese people have worked hard for their education standard. They have worked hard for their health. My dear students, from that perspective, I have told you that please go on the Uncertain Glory books of written by Amrita Sen and Jean Darej. There we have seen that how beautifully they have made the difference. A stark reality is there. China has grown faster. Because we see that if you compare that since 1980s, the Chinese economy has grown 800%, but Indian economy has grown only 200%. You just see, even it has grown 800% and Indian economy only 200%, means 4 times more growth, but still the people of China, their income distribution, their 1% are getting only 14% and 1% here are getting 22%. You just see. Means per capita income also, if you consider that Chinese people are earning 5 times more, even the poorest people are earning 5 times more than the Indian population. We are finding that if you consider that $2 per day, the Chinese people are much less, 10 times less than the India. Means inequality is high, very high in India. What the reason is that the secondary education, In India, the level of education is very low. The share of Indian population with secondary schooling is less than 15%. China has achieved even in 1970 much higher education standard and as well as more employable, skillful education system much before that. Besides being an authoritarian country, China has done much more for the population's human research development work. They have done more on the capital, human capital. They have developed more on the human capital. That is the reason their people, they've made the product and the product were having the salability. So this is the reason that China has inequality is much less in China in comparison to India. Even you are finding that 1991, there was a restructuring has been there done. A structural adjustment policies has been done in India. But we are finding inequality is growing. So, my dear students, from that perspective, this is very important. The second news related to the patent law, India's Patent Act of 1970, that how India rejected bad patents. The author is having the all the high words regarding the India Patents Act, that strong standards for patents have filtered the bad from the good with the least administrative and financial burden. Very interesting article. Both the authors, these are the Firoz Ali and Sudarshan Rajgopal, they are the patent experts. They are telling that in 2005, India made some remarkable amendments to the Indian Patent Act of 1970. After the amendment made in 2005, much hue and cry has been there, not only by the multinational global pharmaceutical company, but even by the USA and as well as the European Union. But in that, in the W, this has come as per the WTO norms also, and this by this amendment in the 2005, India has rejected bad patents from the far greater number than any developed countries. They are talking about the Section 3D of the same act. It is such a good system that 1,723 pharmaceutical applications rejected by the Indian Patent Office between 2009 and 2016. You just see 1,723 applications rejected. It is a great number. See, the patenting of these things are having the so many, important aspects. There was a case in the Supreme Court. It was the Novartis companies there, no? Novartis company is there in the Supreme Court, and we have found that in this one, Section 3D, and the Supreme Court has also made the Indian Patent Act very much, having a good stand. The reason is that this Patent Act involves the inventive steps. So inventive steps is very important. It should be totally new methodology should be there. The invention should be new, involve an inventive steps, and should be capable of industrial applications, and were the most frequently used grounds for the rejection. So these all things are there, means innovativeness, inventive schemes, industrializations, these all schemes has been taken care of. That is why the Supreme Court's ruling in the Novartis case in April 2013 has found that this Patent Act is very robust. So this is a very good step regarding, this is also important for civil services. My dear students, you require to make a write-up on the Indian Patent Act to 1970 and the amendment of Novartis and the Supreme Court ruling in 2013. Just go and have a reading of it and you will find that it is very important for a civil services perspective. There is an interview that there is not going to be a war between India and China today. Very important article, interview is there. It is here. The China's India war collision course of on the roof of the world. So this scholar that the Bertil Linter, he is telling about that there will be no possibility of the India-China war as such. He is talking about the 1962 war in Genesis. He has gone in much in detail. Now he is telling that India for the China, the Burma, Myanmar is having very important role to play in Myanmar. Because on the Myanmar side, if you see the map of the China, then the eastern side is more developed and Myanmar is closer to it. So they will have this Myanmar, they will use as a frontal for the sea. So China is pushing the idea of the canal, that is from Gulf of Thailand to the Andaman Sea, and this Kra Canal, KRA Canal, KRA Canal, this is important. I'm just showing you some of the photographs of the canal here. Here you just see at this position, you just see this China from this side. Here is the canal, this location is there. The location, if you find that, yes, Kra Canal, the Gulf of Siam and Andaman Sea, this canal. Because of the Malacca Strait, the China is having much congestion. So coming from the South China Sea, if you cross from the Gulf of Siam to Andaman, and this way they will come to the Myanmar, this Rangoon and this area, definitely this is, will be a great frontal face for the China. So this is also one important aspect. So from considering all these aspects, there also one news is there that China is telling that Afghanistan can use the Belt Road Initiative, that is the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor. So we are finding that the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor and this type of the things are important from the China's strategy point of view. So my dear students, coming from the backward, we will see that yes, here this news related to the Kra Canal. Here they are talking about the Afghanistan. They have got that will have access to the China-Pakistan Economic Corridor, Indian Patent Act, and we have also seen about the inequality in the inequality, the pod taxi, and we have seen also International Atomic Energy Agency, and we have seen this one, the North Korea conflict, Shravan Bela Gola. And this news, then we have also seen line of actual control. So basically, we have seen all those things in a perspective. It is required that you must make a write-up on all these topics in a few words so that the concept remains clear to you. Thank you, my dear student.